This video is a follow-on to the basic training videos and provides some inspiration on how to use more Cognigy features. I'm going to visit an imaginary site that lets me check flight status across multiple airlines. If I linger on the page, the bot asks me if I need help, and I do. I'll start by asking about my flight status. I'll give the chatbot some answers one by one. I get my results back from the Aviation Stack API, and now I'll click on a result to see the flight details. Let's do another search, but this time I want to take more of a natural language approach. I'll say, I need to check my flight from ORD to SFO on United. Note that the bot skips all of the questions it asked before because it has identified the airports and the airline automatically. I can switch up my word order and use city names instead of airport codes. So I can say I need to check my flight arriving in San Francisco from Chicago on American. The bot understands regardless of how I express myself. If I leave out a detail, the bot will make sure it asks me. So I'll say I need to check my flight arriving in LAX from Chicago. All right, so let's take this apart one by one and see how it's built in Cognigy. Let's start with looking at how Cognigy recognizes cities and airport names. I'll go to my agent and look at my lexicons. Out of the box, Cognigy ships with lexicons for airport codes, so that gave me a head start in creating this agent. I also created a lexicon for airlines that are common in the US. Note a couple of things here. I've added synonyms to a number of the airlines to reflect the ways that users might refer to these terms. I've also given each of them a slot name. You might remember from other videos that you can upload and download lexicons as a CSV file if it's easier to edit them in Excel. I've also created a miscellaneous icon for different entities that I might want to track in a conversation. In this case, I want Cognigy to recognize different ways of specifying an arrival destination and a departure destination. Okay, my lexicons are all set up. Now let's switch over to the flow and look at the Nlu configuration. We're tackling a simple use case here, checking flight status. So I've just set up one flow. In a normal scenario, you'll have numerous different use cases and you'll likely build them in separate flows. This allows you to create your conversations modularly, making it easy to organize and reuse flows. I'll click on Nlu at the top of the screen, and I have just two intents, a flight status intent and a search again intent. With just two intents, I don't need to create any intent hierarchy, so let's just click on flight status. To recap our earlier video, to create an intent in Cognigy, you add example sentences that teach the system how to recognize and predict user intent. I've done that here with examples like what's the status of my flight and checking on my flight status. I've also added annotations to my sentences. So in the case of is my flight from SFO to ORD on time, I've associated SFO and ORD to the slots that I defined in my airport code lexicon. Here I also add an example of specifying the airline name. The point of this is to reduce the number of example sentences you need to create manually, essentially having placeholders that stand in for slot matches. The search again intent is a little different. This is just to reset the flight details when the user wants to search for another flight. I gave it special casing to note that this intent is typically triggered by a quick reply button, but I also added some example sentences in case the user writes a sentence instead of clicking on a button. Let's quickly look at attached lexicons, and you can see that I've turned on the airlines, airport codes, and miss lexicons so that I can use them with my flow. Finally, I created a slot filler. Slot fillers are helpful when you want the Nlu to keep an eye out for a specific slot match. I wanted to watch out for airline names so that I don't have to ask the user which airline they're on if they've already shared that information. All right, now let's look at the flow. I'll open the interaction panel and say hi. you'll see that we immediately hit the once node, which then leads to the on first time branch. This is where you can put any messages to the user that should only be output once in a conversation. Now I'll say I want to check on my flight from SFO to ORD on United. Let's see what's going on. In the chart, you'll see a couple of nodes that we'll talk about later, copy data to context and the if node. For now, let's go to the lookup node where we check the user's intent. We get a match for the flight status intent, and then we hit the fill aviation slots node. What's this? It's a special node created as a Cognigy extension. Cognigy extensions are nodes you can create using the same pattern Cognigy uses to build out our out-of-the-box nodes. If I click on the plus sign and go to extensions, I can see all of the aviation-oriented extensions I created for this project. In many cases, you don't have to create extensions. Cognigy gives a lot of flexibility in the standard nodes and code nodes, and for retrieving external data, HTTP request nodes. But it can be nice to package more complex logic up into extensions just to make life easier for Flow developers. The fill aviation slots node is how I approached mapping the right slot match to the departure or destination city. A user can say, I'm leaving San Francisco, I'm departing San Francisco, my flight is from San Francisco, and they can say these things before or after they specify what their destination is. The logic for this isn't too complicated, but it's even simpler if I put it into its own node type. Next, we hit this question node. What airline are you flying on? Now, we didn't hit this node in the example I just showed. Why? Because if I go to context, you'll see I turned on skip if answer exists in context. Because I set up a slot filler for this already, Cognigy is always on the lookout for this slot match. If it's already in the context, it will skip this question. A similar logic applies for the subsequent questions. If the answer is already in the context, Cognigy isn't going to ask the question. Imagine if I said, I want to check on my flight from SFO to ORD on United, and the next question the bot asked me was, where are you flying from? Well, it wouldn't be the best experience, and the bot wouldn't be acting intelligently. All right, now I'll clear the interaction panel using my favorite shortcut, Control-B or Command-B, and I'll show you what happens if I leave out one piece of information. I'll say I want to check my flight from SFO on United. Now it asks me for my departure city. Once I provide all the information it needs, it gives me a confirmation message. Here we use some Cognigy script to output the context variables I've collected so far. I get these values from the Cognigy context, which you can see here. The next step is I run another Cognigy extension called getSchedule. GetSchedule passes the departure city, arrival city, and airline to the Aviation Stack API and returns results. Behind the scenes, I'm just making an HTTP request to the Aviation Stack API and passing it the API key that I defined in my connection here. I could have done the same thing using an HTTP request node, but it's cleaner and easier for a non-technical user to do it this way. And to make it even easier, I've defined tokens that hide the underlying Cognigy script I used to get to the context variables. Finally, I use a show schedule results node to output the results. The reason I do this rather than using a say node is that I want to use a web chat plugin to output that nice table we saw in the chat interface. I could achieve this in a say node just using a data payload, but using extensions makes it less error prone and it's simple for a non-technical user. So at this point, we've output the table of results, which you see here. And this is using one of our out-of-the-box web chat plugins that you'll find on GitHub. When you click on a row in the table, it passes some data back to you. This is why I added the copy data to context node at the beginning of my flow. In the if, I check to see if I have table data passed back to me. That's the data from the table of flight results. And if so, I render that nice visual of the flight details. To do this, I'm using our Adaptive Cards plugin that lets me create some nice visualizations in the chatbot. Again, you can find this plugin on GitHub. If the user wants to search for another flight, I want to clear out all of the data we've collected so far. I present a button that says search for another flight, and I use this see intent notation to tell Cognigy that when the user clicks this button, I want to trigger the search again intent. Let's look at that here. You can see I'm removing each context element from the Cognigy context using a remove from context node. And finally, I let the user know they can search again. How can we preview this? There's a quick way you can use for testing, and then there's the approach you'll actually use to embed the chat on the website. The simple way to preview is go to Deploy Endpoints and create a web chat endpoint as I've done here. If you look at my configuration, I've put links to the plugins I'm using, one for the table display and the other for adaptive cards. I've also set a nice background image. To preview, just click Open Web Chat. To embed the web chat on your website, you can use our simple embed codes. You'll find them on GitHub in the documentation for our web chat widget. I'll walk you through what I've done. In my HTML, I've linked to my web chat widget and my plugins, just like I did in the configuration in the UI. To start my web chat, I've executed the init web chat method. More on that in a moment. One other thing I've done is add some styling to my web chat widget. Cognigy makes it easy to customize any aspect of the web chat. I wanted to make mine a little bit wider so it would be comfortable for users to see the table of scheduled results. You can see full documentation on customizing the web chat widget here. Let's take a quick look at options for the embed code. If I go to GitHub, I can see all of the options available to me and quickly see some examples on Code Sandbox. For example, see this one of embedding the web chat using web chat plugins. You can use Code Sandbox as a quick way to test your embed code. Just save and you can preview the change immediately. I hope you enjoyed learning about Cognigy from this video and got a little deeper into the possibilities of what you can build. Thanks!